מסכת מנחות, פרק שמיני, page 78, we are the Mishnah. Yesterday we discussed the Thanksgiving offering that combined the offering with the lechamim, with the loaves. Today we, in a way, juxtaposes. We bring another two biblical concept of having the offering, not just the offering itself, but additional lechamim, additional loaves. And there are two are demiluim and nezirut. Let's go to our Mishnah Kedosha. Hamiluim hayuvaim kamatza shebatoda. The initiation offering were brought like the matzah of the thanksgiving, like the todah offering. So this is the time of the tabernacle, the time of the Mishkan, as the Torah described in fully, mainly in the books of Vayikra and Bamidbar. So the Mishkan was first built the time that the Jewish people wander in the wilderness, and Aharon, the biblical first high priest, and his sons were inaugurated as Kohanim. They brought a series of offerings, and that series called in the Torah concept Miluim, which included a ram, referred to as El HaMiluim, the ram of initiation, and three different types of menachot. This is the early part of Leviticus in chapter 8. So the Mishnah said, Hayu va'im kam matza sheba todah. They brought like the matzah of the todah, of the thanks offering. Chalot, the loaves, and ur kikim. So as we said yesterday, the best way to translate is a few different translations, but here they use the word wafers. Urvucha, some said urvicha, and the loaves poached in water and made with oil. So the loaves of leavened bread that accompanied the thank offering were not brought with the ram of inauguration. So as we said, there are two. One is the miluim, the second one is hanezirut. Hanezirut. So the nazir, the nazirite, haitava shtei yadot b'matza shebatoda. They consist of two parts of the matza of toda offering, which is the loaves of the nazir, one who commit himself to stay apart from drinking wine, etc., the Nazirite. So the loaves of the Nazir offering consist of two of the three types of matzah loaves of the Todah offering, as we explain and follow. Chalot ur kikin ve'en ba revucha. So they have chalot, they have rikukin. Rikukin, as we said, it's a wafer. But there's no revucha. So it describes, when we describing the loaves required for Nazir as part of his offering brought upon the completion of his vow, he commit himself, Stam Nazirut Shloshim Yom, 30 days. So the Torah in the book of Numbers, chapter 6, describe only chalot blulot bashemen, the loaves mixed with oil, the chalot of our Mishnah, and rekikei. Like, as we said, matzot wafers that meshuchim bashamen, smear with oil, the rekikim that we discuss in the Mishnah. But however, no revucha or leavened loaves are mentioned. So the Mishnah said, nimtza, so thus, they consist of 10 asara kabaim yerushalmiyot, since the three varieties of matzah for the todah require total of 15 kav of flour, as we discussed yesterday, and the Nazir's loaves consist of two out of three part of the Todah loaves, the two variety brought by Nazir call for just 10 kavs of flour. Shehen shisha esronot, and here's the two different ve'ad vayin, or some said the odayan, said two different way, but which basically shisha esronot, which is equal 6 esronot of the axis, which since each variety of todah loaves consisted of three and a third esronim as measured by the Torah, the time of the wilderness standard, this offering required double that amount, which amounts to 6 2/3 esronot. So the girsa that we mentioned earlier, ve'ad vayin, it's a plural of ve'od, literally and some. So in that context, it refers to an extra fraction of an isaron, 1/3, contained in every variety. Some Rashi and others use the word ve'od dayan, but either way, it's the idea that it's a little more menah nemileh. So since we learn in Mishnah that the loaves that accompany the ram of inauguration of the tabernacle consists of three types of matzah brought with thanks offering, the loaves, the wafers, and the loaves poached in water and made with oil, so here the Gemara asks, Menah hanei mile, how do you know that? Where it's driving from. Amar Rav Chisda, Amar Rav Chama bar Guria de Amar Kra. This is a pasuk in Vayikra, in Leviticus chapter 8, verse 26. Umisal amatzot asher lifnei Hashem, lakach chalat matzah achat, vechalat lechem shemen achat, verakik echad. The pasuk said, and out of the basket of unleavened bread that was brought before God, he took one unleavened cake and one cake of oil bread and one water. So that's twice appear in the Torah, not a miluim. So we derive from that, bishlama chalot, chalot, cake are cakes. Rakik, wafer, is rakik, which is a wafer. However, shemen maininhu. When we use the term chalat lechem shemen, what is the oil, bread? What is referring to? Lav revucha, isn't that referring to matzah porch in water and made with oil? Later you see in page 89 expansion of that. But anyway, matkifla Rav Avya, Eima anta dim shicha, the mishcha. So the oil bread is referring to a cake of oil. Ela kedarash Rav Nachman bar Rav Chisda mishmed Rabbi Tavla. The Torah said in Leviticus chapter 6 verse 13, Ze korban Aaron uvanav asher ikrivu l'Hashem biyom mashach oto. This is the offering of Aaron and his son, which is bring to God on the day that he was anointed, and that's the specification, the tenth part of the ephah, of a fine flour meal, etc., etc. V'chima lamadnu levnav biyom imashcho. And what we learn with regard to our own sons, which is the ordinary Kohanim, from the instruction for the high priest, the day that he was anointed. Ela, rather, the verse, makish chinucho leimashcho, the verse juxtaposes the meal offering brought is by ordinary Kohen during his inauguration with a meal offering brought by the Kohen Gadol when he was anointed. Ma himashcho revucha af chinucho revucha. Just as the meal offering brought by Kohen Gadol when he is anointed is poured in water, so too the meal offering brought by an ordinary Kohen during his inauguration is poured in water. So similarly, the loaf brought with the ram of the inauguration of the tabernacle included loaves poured in water. Amar Rav Chisda, Kohen Gadol mitkarev la'avoda, tzarich shtei esronot ha'efa, achat leimashcho ve'achat lechinucho. Mar Rav Ashi amar shalosh. So Rav Chisda said, the Kohen Gadol that who approaches the temple service on the day that he is anointed is required to bring two meal offering consist of 2/10 of Eifah. One for the fact that he is anointed as a Kohen Gadol, must bring a daily meal offering for the Kohen Gadol, and one for his inauguration. And Mar Rav Ashi says he required 3/10 of Eifah. So it's appear like they are disputed, but the Gemara said no, ve'lo pligei, it's not a disputation. They don't disagree. Ha, the avad avodah kshu kohen ediot. First one, when he did the avodah, the right of the kohen, when he was an ordinary kohen. Ha, the lo avad avodah kshu kohen ediot. The other one who was not yet performed the temple service as an ordinary kohen, so obviously it's different. So he must therefore bring three tenths, one for his inauguration, and as an ordinary kohen, and one for his inauguration as a kohen gadol, which is different, and one of the daily meal offering of the kohen gadol. Nezirut hayta ba shtei yadot kamatza shebatoda. The Mishnah teaches that the loaves that accompany the offering that the nazir bring upon completion of his period of nezirut will come with only two parts, parallel to the type of matzah that comes with thanks offering, loaves and wafer, but not matzah parched in water. Tanu Rabbanan, the Torah said in Parashat Todah in Leviticus chapter 7, Shlamav, his peace offering, לרבות שלמי נזיר לעשרת קבין ירושלמית ולרבעית שמן. That's what we learn in the Mishnah. So we derive from that in the inclusion of Nazir peace offering in the halachot that it's accompanying meal offering must consist of 10 kav ירושלמיות and 1/4 of log of oil, like just like the measurement required for the cakes and wafers of the thanks offering. יכול לכל מה שאמור בעניין. One might have thought that this apply to all the status with regard to this matter of the thank offering. And that one brings the three types of matzah consisting of 15 kavim Yerushalmim and a half log of oil. Talmud lomar matzot. So that was said in the book of Numbers, chapter 6, the word unleavened bread. So you have here the indication that Nazir's meal offering consists only of matzah loaves and matzah wafer and not matzah parched in water. My Talmudah, what is the Torah derivation by which matzah indicate that loaves parched in water were not brought? Amar Papa davar shenabar bo matzot lapuki revucha. Papa said that an item that is called matzah, we have here exclusion, loaves parched in water, which is not stated matzot. ללא נאמר בו מצות. דבר רבי ישמעאל תנא מצות כלל, חלות ורקיקים פרט, כלל ופרט, אין בכלל על מה שפרט. In the daily we said רבי ישמעאל 13 principles, one of them is this one. So here we talk about generalization and details. So you go by the word מצות. מצות is indication of a very general unleavened bread generalization. Then the Torah said חלות ורקיקים, loaves of a fine flour and unleavened wafer bread of oil. So that's obviously you go to details. And then klal uprat. So here you have the Torah stated a generalization and then a details. So the generalization includes only what is in the detail. Ein baklal ela ma shebaprat. So the Gemara said, therefore, chalot, the loaves, and rekikin, and wafers, in, that's part that's included in the Nazir's meal offering, midei acharina lo, while other items are not. Page 78b, Mishnah Kedusha. Ashuchet et ha-todah lifnim velachma, חוץ לחומה, לא קדש הלחם. So, here, the Mishnah Kedusha speaks about the case that one who slaughtered the thanks offering in a way properly, it's inside the Azara, inside the courtyard, and the temple courtyard, שוחט את הדודה לפנים ולחמה חוץ לחומה. While its loaves were outside the wall. So, lo kadash alechem, the bread is not sanctified. The Torah describes the loaves as being al zevach todat shlamav, which literally translate will mean on the sacrifice of the todat shlamim. So this is taken to teach us that the very must nearby, so if the loaves were outside the wall while the Todah was slaughtered inside the temple courtyard, the loaves do not contain, do not have the sanctity. If you remember on page 77, you see it also other places, the whole story of Choma Beit Pagi. But anyway, Shchata, עד שלא קרמו פניה בתנור, ואפילו קרמו כולם חוץ מאחד מהם, לא קדש הלחם. So if he slaughtered before they become crushed in the oven, until they become crushed, the dough does not have a status of bread and cannot satisfy the Todah's requirement, the lechem, the loaves. The loaves had already been kneaded, shaped and placed in the oven to bake in the time of the Todah offering was slaughtered, but they are not yet baked to the point of forming a crush, so they do not become consecrated with the slaughter of the sacrifice. Vafilu, and even if all were crushed, except for one, the bread is not sanctified. Amara. Mai chutz lachoma. What the meaning of the statement in the Mishnah outside of the wall? Rabbi Yochanan amar chutz lechomat Beit Pagi. So that's outside of Yerushalayim. Beit Pagi is the outer part of the wall that circles around Yerushalayim. The Afsar, Igmoim Bavametzia, ninth, that's in the head of the animal, it's called Beit Pagi. That's the also, in that sense, the outer of the wall. V'Reish Lakish amar chutz lechomat ha'azara. V'Reish Lakish said it's outside of the wall of Temple Courtyard. V'Reish Lakish amar chutz lechomat ha'azara be'inan al besamuch. V'Reish Lakish said that it's outside of the wall of Temple Courtyard because the Pasuk said with regard to loaves of the thanks offering in Leviticus 7, then he shall sacrifice it with all thanks offering and unleavened cakes mingled with oil. So we require that the thank offering be slaughtered strictly with al, which is with the loaves nearby. If the loaves are outside the wall of the Azara of the Temple Courtyard, they are not considered nearby, obviously. Rabbi Yochanan amar chutz lechomat Beit Pagi, aval chutz la'azara kadosh. But if it's merely outside of the temple courtyard, they may be eaten, they are consecrated. Ve'lo ba'inan al besamoch, and it does not require that the thanks offering slaughter strictly with, accompanied with loaves nearby. Va'iplegu ba'chad hazimna, but didn't they already disagree with regard to this matter another time? Litnan. This is the Mishnah in Psachim 63. That's the slaughtering of the Pesach offering. Ashochel et haPesach al haChametz over below the safe. One slaughtered the Pesach offering on leavened bread, still in his possession, so he transgressed a positive commandment. That's the Pasuk in Exodus 34. You shall not sacrifice the blood of my offering with leavened bread, neither shall the offering of the festival of Pesach be left until the morning. Rabbi Yudah said also, even one who slaughtered the daily afternoon offering on Pesach with the leavened bread in his possession transgresses the prohibitions. V'amar Reish Lakish l'olam eno chayav ad shiyeh o l'shochet o l'zorek kol echad min ha'chavurayim o ba'azara. He says actually the responsibility, the liability, unless the leavened bread is in the possession of one who slaughtered the offering, or one who sprinkled the blood, or one who member of that chabura, of that group, and the leavened bread is with that person in the temple courtyard. The Rabbi Yochanan amar af al pi she'ein imo ba'azara. Rabbi Yochanan says, one is liable even if the leavened bread is not with the person in the temple courtyard. So that's the meaning of, by him, the word al. So tzricha. We need to state the dispute concerning both matter. Di itmar ba'i ba'ika amar Rabbi Yochanan kol echad eite b'yisur akai. Aval le'inyan mekadesh lechem eim amodel l'Reish Lakish. So Rabbi Yochanan said it whenever there is leavened bread, its owner stand in violation of the prohibition against owning leavened bread at that time. But with regard to the manner of the consecration of the loaves of the thanks offering, why can say that he concedes to Reish Lakish that the loaves are inside the temple courtyard when the thanks offering is slaughtered? The item mibefnim kadosh, abrai lo kadosh. If they are consecrated, but if the outside they are not, ויתמר בהה בהה כמה ריש לקיש, אבל בהך הם עמודו לרבי יוחנן, so therefore צריך, it's necessary to state a dispute concerning both. תנא כבתי לרבי יוחנן, שוחט את התודה לפנים, ולחמה חוץ לבית פגי. לא קדש הלחם. So if he does that, the loaves are not consecrated. שחטד שלא קרמו פניה בתנור, the Mishnah teaches, if he slaughtered the thanks offering before the surface of the loaves form a crash in the oven, so the loaves were not consecrated. Ma'anan emila, how do you know it? The Tanur Rabbanan, the Pasuk said in Leviticus 7, verse 13, al chalot lechem chametz yakriv korbanu al zevach. They said with cakes of leavened bread, he shall present his offering with the sacrifice of his peace offering for thanks. Melamed shein alechem kadosh lehem kin karmu paneh v'tanur. The consecration is upon the crushing in the oven. Yakriv korbanu al zevach. The Pasuk said that he bring his offering, should present his offering with the sacrifice. So that teaches us, melamed shein alechem kadosh lehem b'shchitat hazevach, that the loaves are consecrated only upon the slaughter of the offering. Zevach toda, the sacrifice of his peace offering for thanks. Melamed shein shachat shelo lishlan lo kadash alechem, teaches that if he slaughtered the offering not for its sake, the loaves were not consecrated. תנו רבנן יוצאים בצד נע ומצא שורה עשויה באילפס. The sages teaches us that one fulfills the obligation to eat matzah on Pesach with half done, which is not fully baked. Matzah, and with matzah with a stew pot, which is rather than the baked in the oven. My matzah nah, what exactly constitutes half done matzah? אמר רב יהודה, אמר שמואל, כל שפורסה ואין חוטין נמשכים המנה. It is any matzah that is sufficiently baked, such that if one bakes it, thread of dough are not drawn from it. אמר רבא, וכן לחמי תודה, the same loaf of thanks offering, if the loaves were already half done at the time of the slaughter of the thanks offering, they are consecrated. So the Gemara asks, פשיטה, that's obvious. Here, with regard to matzah, the term bread is written, Deuteronomy 16. Hach alechem k'tiv, v'hach alechem k'tiv. And here, the loaves of the thanks offering, the term bread is written. Ma'o letema echad, amar achmana, shelo itol parus. Torah said one, that one not take a sliced bread of the thanks offering. Kamash melan, so therefore, we, Rav teach us that one, once it's baked to that point, it's considered as one loaf and is valid for the thanks offering. Itmar, we state that there is a dispute among the Amoraim with regard to what? Todah sheshchatal 80 chalot, the thanks offering that one slaughtered accompanied with by 80 loaves. Chizki amar kadshu 40 mitoch 80. Chizki says 40 of the 80 loaves are consecrated. ורבי יוחנן אמר לא קדשו 40 מתוך 80. רבי יוחנן says not even 40 of the 80 loaves are consecrated. אמר רבי זרע כל מודים אחד אמר לי קדשו 40 מתוך 80 קדשו. He expelled out 40 out of 80 should be consecrated. אלי קדשו 40 אלי קדשו 80 לא קדשו. He said the other way. So they're not. כי פליגה בסתמה, the disputation is disagree, one bring 80 loaves without specification. So Marsa bar Chizkiah hold le'acharayut kamitkaven, he intend to consecrate only 40 of them, but he brought 80 in order to guarantee that it will be sufficient loaves. Marsa bar le'korban gadol kamichaven, Rabbi Yochanan hold that he intends to bring a large offering of 80 loaves, and consequently none of the loaves are consecrated. Abaye amar dechu le'alma le'acharayut kamitkaven. Rabbi Yeh said that they all agree that it's for guarantee that there is there will be sufficient loaves. ובכלי שרת מקדשין של המידת כמפלגי, the consecrated vessel, the appropriate measure without the intention of one bringing the offering. מר סבר חזקי ההולד, כלי שרת מקדשין של המידת, ומר סבר רבי יוחנן הולד, a כלי שרת אין מקדשין של המידת, the service vessel do not consecrate item without intention. רב פאפה אמר דחולי על מקלי שרת מקדשין של המידת, ואחה בסכין כמפלגי, they disagree with regards to a slaughtering knife. מר סבר חזקי ההולד, סכין כיוון דלת לתוך, סכין מקדש בכלי שרת, that the knife consecrated item as a service vessel does. ומר סבר, רבי יוחנן holds, כיוון דלת לתוך, since the knife has no inside, אינה מקדשת ככלי שרת. It does not consecrate item as a service vessel does. ואיקה דאמרי, and those who said, רב פאפה אמר דחולי על מקלי שרת אין מקדשין למידת. רב פאפה said, everyone agrees that service vessel consecrated item only with intention. והכה בסכין כמפלגי. And here they disagree with regard to the ability of the slaughtering knife to consecrate without intention. מר סבר סכין אלימה מכלי שרת, דאף על גב דלית לתוך מקדשה, חזקי ההולדס, that the power of the knife to consecrate item is stronger than the other service vessel, as even though it is no inside it, consecrates item, and therefore it also consecrate item without intention. And Rabbi Yochanan Umar Savar, the other one, Sakin lo alima le mikli sharet, that the power of the knife to consecrate item is not stronger than the other service vessel, and like all service vessel, it does not consecrate item without intention.